Hi YouTube, this is Prash from PROHDGaming. Today I'll be showing you how to create 2560 to 1440p resolution videos in PowerDirector. PowerDirector 12, 13 and 14. I'm using PowerDirector 14, which is the latest version. I'm using ultimate version. And PowerDirector 14 and the previous version do have a capability to, you can produce up to 4K videos. But there is no option to create 25 by 16 to 1440p resolution videos. Even if you create your own custom profile, there is no such options. And today I'll be showing you how to do that. 1440p also be called 2K, and a lot of people want it. YouTube also allows 1440p video. I mean, of course, it allows up to 8K now, so 1440p would be there. So today we'll be creating a custom profile. Which is not allowed in normal way by PowerDirector, but we have to do a workaround by editing an INI file. I'll show you exactly what to do to get 1440p either 30fps or 60fps. So here the my sample clip for Call of Duty Black Ops 3 game videos, which I'll be doing a full movie soon, so look out for that on my channel. We'll go to produce. I already imported it and put it in the timeline. Now I'm going to produce. And I'll be choosing 2D standard 2D, and then go to H.264 format, which is MP4 you have to choose, which is the best format for YouTube videos. Now, once you choose MP4 here, you have to choose, you have to add a profile. So you have to click on this plus button and add a custom profile. So we'll be going to be making 2K60fps, which is also called 1440p60fps. That's the name and description. We'll go to video. We'll choose 1080p for now. Just bear with me. Just do that. And we'll choose 59.94 or 60. But I'll be going through. I mean, I'll be choosing 1594, which works best and it produces faster. I'll be choosing bitrates as my choice. Higher you keep, better the video quality. But YouTube do have a suggested bitrates for all the video formats, 60fps or 30fps. On a various resolution. I'll leave a link to that particular guidelines, which is called advanced video editing encoding option, in the description below, so for you to check out. We'll go to audio. We'll choose 384 bit, which is what YouTube suggests. Now we'll click OK. Now the profile has been created. What now we have to do, we just have to close this project, and we'll ask you to save, and we'll just save it on a desktop. We just call it tutorial. Now you have to go to a folder called the folder in app data. So you just have to type in your search bar, which is, this is Windows 10, so it will also be applicable for Windows 7 or Windows 8.1. Basically you can go to run and do this, but I'm doing directly and it works in this version of Windows. So percentage app data percentage. So this folder will open, which is called app data roaming. I'll leave the details in the description where exactly you have to go. You have to click Sabling. You have to go to PowerDirector, and you have to choose your version, which is mine is 14. I had 13, which I uninstalled and installed this, so the files are still there. You have to go to this file called profile.ini. You have to double click it, and it should open in Word by default, because I did open in the past, so it is remembering it. Windows remembering and opening it in Word. If it doesn't, you have to right click and choose a program, which is a Notepad. Now we have to find, this is the detail of profile you created. So name and stuff, description you added. Now you don't have to do anything else, just you have to do these steps, which I'm gonna do. You have to find width and height of the video, which as per the options we had, we chose 1920 by 1080p. So this we have to change. So let me change this to width should be 2560 and height should be 1440p, 1440. And that's it. Frame rate is fine. Bit rates are fine. Everything is okay. We just have to save it. And we'll close it. Now we'll open the project which we saved on desktop. should work fine now. Your video should be produced in 1440p and with the bit rates you wanted. So I'll go to MP4 custom. Now I have only one profile. So if you do this exercise, make sure you have only one profile selected. Only one custom profile created, because the same INI file will hold all the profiles you created. So if you want to edit it, it will be too much confusion for you and you might end up screwing everything up. So make sure if you are gonna create profiles like this, you create one by one. So I deleted all my profile for this tutorial and to show you it's very easy if you have only one profile, custom profile created. So now we'll try to, all settings are okay, hardware video encoder is selected, which I need, and I'll just keep the name same, and I'll click start. Now it's producing in 2516 to 1440p, and I'll show you once the production is finished, and I'll come back when it's done. Now the video has been produced, we'll go to the output folder, which is formats in rendered file, and this is the video, which is the latest one as on today's date, and we'll click on that and you see it is 1440p 60fps. And just to show you the description that I'm not faking it, we'll go right click, we'll go to properties, we'll go to details, and you see here all video attributes. You can see here your frame rates, your bit rates, everything. So this is how you should do it. And there might be an error when you click produce. There should be an error which is like this. It should state like this: please, production unsuccessful. Please ensure your graphic card driver is up to date. And it also say you make sure your latest version of Windows Media Player and QuickTime is installed, which you should do. And QuickTime updated version is must, because it helps PowerDirector in producing MP4 videos and high quality videos. Of course, it makes sense to keep your graphic cards up to date, graphic cards drivers up to date. That might be new drivers, might be conflicting in exceptional cases, but with this new version, I highly doubt that there would be any conflict. So I just did 2 days before I updated the latest NVIDIA driver on my 980 Ti. So for me, everything was up to date, but still this error popped up. So I gone through this forum and I found out the solution, which is here. So this guy also tried to do it and he could find himself the solution. So it is here. I'll leave this link in the description below for you to check it out. But I'll also show you what exactly he did and what I also did to get rid of that error, even with the latest version which I just installed this morning. So I'll go to this folder called HKey User. Basically you have to go to your registry edit. So again we'll go to search bar and type REG edit. Of course you need to have admin right foot to do this. Now you have to go to this folder called HKey_current_user, then go to software, then go to Savalink, and go to CES functional logger, and go to data. Now all this data value should be zero. As you see right now on my screen, on my computer, it's zero. And at the time when I had that error, there was one or two key field, data field was one and one, in the bracket also one, and at the last data was also one. So make sure you go to this, double click on it and make it zero. It will make everything zero if you put zero there. So everything should be zero, and if it is one, that's the reason you're having the error. I don't know the technicality behind this, why it was there, but I did this and it worked. So you just do that and just close it. There is nothing to save here, it automatically saved, and close it, and then it should work fine. I mean, if you have any problem, let me know. I'll try to help you out. So that's it, folks. Thank you very much for joining me on this video. And as you know, my channel is all about quality gaming, and PowerDirector has helped me a lot since the beginning of my channel 3 years back. And all my videos, if you see, I have more than 530 videos on my channel, which all are produced and rendered. Even the 4K videos which I have recently started uploaded when I got my 980 Ti graphic card, which helps me in either medium or high setting, I can play 4K, 4K gaming for latest titles as well. You see titles like Batman Arkham Knight with the DLCs which are uploaded in 4K. Only the Batgirl DLC didn't appear in 4K so far. I already escalated to YouTube help and they said they will come back to me. But with this software. What I'm to say, this software is the best for gaming videos, and I highly suggest you to use this software. It's very easy to use. I have a video tutorials for how to render and how to create and render awesome quality gaming videos up to 4K 60fps with the PowerDirector. And this latest version, which cost around $100, right now it's on sale. It's the best deal you can get. It has a lot of features. Besides gaming, you can produce a lot of cool videos for any ceremony you have, like wedding or holiday or Christmas. They have special packs for it, and they also are giving away a lot of freebies. I'll leave a description for the purchase of this product in the description below also for you to check it out. I know a lot of people use other software like Premiere Pro or Sony Vegas, which is fine. It's up to you. But the best thing about PowerDirector is easy to use. It gets the job done. If you want to see the proof, go and check any of my latest videos and you'll see how quality they are. I mean, I can do whatever I want with this. I mean, whatever I want with the video for now, I mean, what I want, it has been accomplished by this software. And the best thing about it is rendering speed. It's so fast. I mean, it produces very, very fast compared to, I have a Sony Vegas installed and it consumes a lot of time for even a 1 hour video. So PowerDirector, even the 4K video, I just leave it overnight and it produces, and it will shut down computer. There is option to shut down your computer once it produces, which most software has it, but I leave PowerDirector overnight to produce all my high quality videos. So I'll be going through a detailed tutorial on this version of PowerDirector, which is the latest version, PowerDirector 14 Ultimate. I'll go through a detailed tutorial on how to produce videos up to 4K in really good quality, and how easy this product is for you to use. And that would be all, and look out for my channel now. I'll be uploading more gaming content soon. I'll be also coming up with tutorial series for PowerDirector 14 soon, so look out for that. Thank you very much guys for joining me, and I'll see you soon.